Hello guys, this is Sharmila and welcome back to my channel Sharmilazkitchen. Today I am going to show you a very beautiful and authentic recipe of Punjabi Chhole Masala or Chana Masala. In this recipe, chickpeas are cooked with onions, tomatoes and lots of spices. To get that rich and dark texture of the Chana Masala, I will be using tea leaves, dried pomegranate seeds and dried gooseberry or Amla. They will give very nice and dark texture in the chana masala. So without wasting any time, let me show you the recipe of chole masala. To cook chole masala, first I have taken 1 cup of chickpeas or garbanzo beans. It needs to be washed and rinsed through for 2-3 times and soak in enough water for 8 hours. After soaking, it will look like this. It has become double in size and fluffy. Now chickpeas are absolutely ready to go in the pressure cooker along with water. Now I am going to be making a masala bag or masala potli, which is very important part in this recipe because it will make the chole masala very flavorful. So let me show you what are the ingredients going in. So in this cloth, first add tea leaves. You must wonder how to get that dark and black texture in the dhaba style pindi chole masala. Because of these tea leaves, it got that texture. Now add aromatic spices. Goes in 2 bay leaves. 2-3 small sticks of cinnamon. 2 green cardamom pods. A small piece of mace. A small piece of nutmeg. 2-3 cloves. And 2 black cardamom pods. Now tie this bag very well so that no masala can come out from this potli. Now it goes in the chole. I'm gonna also add salt to taste. 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda. This baking soda makes the chole melt in mouth when they get cooked. I'm also gonna be adding dried gooseberry or amla, like 7-8 pieces. Close the lid and cook this until 4 whistles done. After 4 whistles done, let the pressure cooker release its pressure. Let me show you the chole. First, remove the masala bag. Squeeze all the juices from this masala bag. Now, let me show you the chole is cooked or not. I am pressing between 2 fingers and you can see it is nicely cooked. We cannot see any dryness in the center of the chole. So it is very nicely cooked. Now keep this aside. Now let's make the masala. In a mixer jar, add 2 onions which is roughly chopped and also 1 teaspoon of dried pomegranate seeds or anadana. Also add some water, about 2 tablespoons. Make a smooth paste out of it. See, the masala paste is also nicely done. Keep it aside also. Now in a frying pan, add 3 tablespoons of oil. Also add 1/2 teaspoon of clarified butter or ghee to bring rich flavor. When the ghee has melted, let's add 1/2 teaspoon of cumin. This is whole cumin. Also add some whole garam masala, like 2-3 green cardamom pods, 3 small cinnamon sticks, 2 cloves. Saute for few seconds, let the aroma of spices come out. Now I'm going to be adding that onion and pomegranate seed paste. Now cook for 2-3 minutes along with 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Salt caramelizes the onion very soon, so it will get cooked fast. When the onion masala is cooking, I have taken 3 tomatoes. I cut the same and also chop roughly and grind it to a smooth paste. When onion leaves the sides, then add tomato puree. Also cook them for more 5-6 minutes until the raw smell of tomato completely gone and oil leaves the sides. In this mixer jar, lot of tomato puree has stuck, so put some water, about 2 tablespoons, and wash it. We will be using this water in the gravy. Next, I am going to be adding some dry masala.
In goes 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 2 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of cumin powder and 2 to 3 teaspoon of coriander powder. Also add 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper powder. Now add that water to this masala so that masala does not get burned from the bottom and stir it nicely. I have taken 1/2 teaspoon of ajwain or carom seeds in this mortar and I'm going to crush it little bit so that the flavor of this ajwain comes out, and it is also good for digestion and gives a beautiful aroma in the pindi chhole. Also add kasori methi. If you have noticed, I have not added any ginger garlic paste in this recipe because the original recipe is like that only. But if you want to add some ginger garlic paste, you can add too. For that, you need only 1 teaspoon ginger garlic paste. So the masala has dried and oozing out the oil from this masala. So now add cooked garbanzo beans or chickpeas or chole. Give it a very nice stir. Let it cook for more 5 to 10 minutes until the gravy becomes thick. So close the lid and cook for 8 to 10 minutes. After cooking for 10 minutes on simmer, the chole masala looks very nice and chole absorb the flavor from the masala. Now the final touch we have to do: add 2 chopped green chilies, some ginger julienne and chopped coriander leaves. The raw flavor of these ingredients makes the chole even more tasty and delicious. Now our melt-in-mouth and delicious pindi chola is ready. It goes well with bhatora, kulcha, naan or any kind of rice. I have given a very beautiful recipe of authentic Amritsari aloo kulcha. You can check it and make with pindi chole.
I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video of authentic chana masala. If you like this recipe, please give this a big thumbs up, share with your family and friends, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you have any feedback or comment, please write me in the comment section below. I'll see you soon again with new video. Till then, take care and bye. Thanks for watching.